Hey, how you doing? This is Kitch, and you are watching me play Dwarf Fortress. I expanded the burrow out a little bit just to let him get recovered, and it looks like Guts is going to be recovered right now, so it seems like we're not really in a hurry anymore. So I thought I would just kind of wait this out and see if we can't get Catton to transform. Days are ticking by fairly slowly, but I don't know. We'll see. I don't remember the date that he transforms. It feels like it hasn't been that long ago. Yeah, just leave the squad stationed out here. That should be fine. I mean, they'll sub out and in as they need to. Perfect green jade. Right, that was going on too. As we have been zoomed to that area 4 times to look at that green jade. Yeah, it looks like Catton's starting to get a little bit thirsty and hungry. Oh, he did it. He turned into it's happening. This is happening. Let's see. I think it's this one. Let's pull it, and we'll unleash the Wergila monster and see what happens. I'm pretty excited. All right, so somebody should be pulling the lever. We just have to wait. There he goes. He's going to pull it. All right. It's been pulled. We'll make sure that that's the right gate. Oh, it's open. Sick him. Go get him. Oh, there we go. Right there. It's on. Oh, that was a death. Can we get where Gila monster is fighting? Boy. Looking to see was there any damage at all done? Not really. Boy, it looks like that was fairly one-sided. Okay, so there goes that plan. That didn't work out. Let's try plan 2. Actually, let's not try plan 2 right now. Let's cancel that. And there were just so many arrows. Let's move the guard up here now, that they should be a little bit safer. And see if they'll take some shots now that they've had time to get some crossbows and get some ammo and all of that stuff. We'll see how that works out. That was rather disappointing. I was hoping that that a little bit more vengeance would be distributed. Now we've got one guy up here. You have a little pain in the neck. You have a crossbow. You don't have any ammo, though. I mean, we should have ammo, right? A lot there. The only thing I could think of is that there weren't any quivers. No, there's quivers. I think it's just that these guys... I've had like 2 or 3 bow kind of things that have just worked out. Most of the time, it ends up like this, though. All right. Well, what's the point in having a military if you're not going to use it, right? Let's just send them out. all you guys that are retreating right now, you're going to miss out. Okay, let's A, B, C, D. All of you move right here. Everybody's leaving. I don't know if I can convince you guys to not do that, but we'll see. Okay, here we go. Gates open. Combat is happening. It's hard to tell. I'm seeing a lot of dead goblins. Apparently not seeing any dead dwarves. Maybe some blinky dwarves, it's hard to tell. I'm going to go ahead and say that we successfully broke that siege, however. Everybody seems to be wanting to go away. Let's send the second reserve out here. Why don't you guys go kill that goblin? No, we wanted, not a station order, a kill order. Back. And who else do we have? Zolok, and he's way up there. Are you running away? Yeah, you're running away. Go tell your friends. Go tell your friends what happens when you take on Sunny Slings. All right. Well, I think that's going to be that. Let's go ahead and remove the civilian alert, and hopefully, if anybody's hurt here, which it looks like you may be. A problem with your arm, your ankles, left ankles, things like that. All right, there goes the second reserve. They're chasing after the goblin. And they got him. ABC, go ahead and cancel all your orders. And, numbers were right. The numbers were all in the proper locations. We've got everybody and their dog out here moving bodies, which is not going to fare well for the fortress, as it's going to be a lot of thoughts and feelings that they don't like. That's okay. We need a little bit of that kind of stuff here and there. Builds character, right? Wait a minute. Look at that. Look at this. Look at this. So if you don't know, if you did not watch the last series, dwarfs wouldn't clean outside. The clean order. They wouldn't clean outside. Blood, vomit, things like that. And we built like a tavern outside, and it would fill up with vomit because people were getting sick going out in the daylight, and it was just disgusting. We had a tavern full of vomit, and no dwarf would clean it because the dwarves were hard coded, where they would ignore the outside as far as the cleaning labor is concerned. That's changed. That's changed. That's fantastic. That puts outside building. That's the whole reason why a lot of the stuff was inside. I usually like to keep my barracks outside because the sun exposure prevents the cave adaptation. And all that stuff. Wow, that is that's actually fantastic. That is a very, very good change. We have llamas starving. I assume maybe I didn't pasture them correctly. Yes. No, but that's actually fantastic. I totally approve of that. Let's build a new body stockpile for corpses. Let's store corpses over here too. Kind of up and out. All right, and all that will be done. Let's see. Can we do anything with the beehive here? Hive. Is it like live honeybees? 15,000. 16,000. 17,000. We got bees, boys and girls. We got bees. Bees, bees, bees. That's making me think of the Oprah Winfrey bees thing. it just makes me laugh thinking about it. If you haven't seen it, look up Oprah Winfrey and bees. It's fantastic. All right. Let's see. What were we doing? We were doing danger room stuff. Add a new task. Let's go ahead and get the rest of these hooked up. And that should be it. That should be it as far as that is concerned. Let's go down here. And let's see. Let's rebuild this entire stockpile. Can you do a copy and paste of the settings of a stockpile? Load save settings. That's a df hack command. Huh. We'll just do it this way. Furniture. And we want to do all the furniture type stuff. Doors, beds, traction benches, thrones, tables, coffins, statues, slabs, those. Weapon racks, cabinets. And I think that may be it. We'll put wheelbarrows there as well. Move that one. That is going to be furniture as well. The floodgates, hatch covers, grates, catapult, ballista, mechanisms. We'll go ahead and put those back there. Windows. Buckets, bins, boxes. Siege ammo, barrels, ballista stuff. Mine carts. Other large tools, that's our musical instrument parts. We'll add that and we will mount sandbags. All right, and that'll be get organized over time.
I'm gonna hang on to this.
I am so happy about the outside cleaning. I don't know if I expressed that earlier, whenever I saw it happening, but it joyful is how I feel about that. That just that makes building outside viable again, which is something that I've enjoyed doing in the past. Catton's getting hauled off. I don't know if there is a way. Let's see. Do we have an empty casket? If we make this a tomb and assign it, can we assign it to Atten? No. Free tomb. Nope. Free tomb. Burial pets. Burial pets. Wait, it seemed like one time I had. There's some setting you can make that makes the pets off by default. Alright, we lost four dwarves so far. Yeah, I don't know. I think probably Katten is just. No, it's still showing up there. Okay, and it is tasked. All right, so maybe they will get put down in there. That's what I was hoping. I was hoping that he wouldn't just die out there and stay where he'd be the monster forever. Have I mentioned how much I really like the cleaning stuff on the outside? That's great. I really, really, really like that. All right, how's this coming along? One more. All right, and it's finished up right here with this guy. That should do it. No, it's not. Need one more. That should have done it. It did. All right, let's pull this lever. And what should happen, in theory, is all of those spears that you see in this danger room here should disappear when that lever's pulled. And they do. All right, that is fantastic. Test two we want to do is assign the pull a lever, and then we want to put that on repeat. And that should make it where the spikes jump up and down. Oh, and I lost my good resolution there. A cyclops. In our farm? I'm confused. All right. Oh, well, I ain't afraid of no cyclops. Let's see. All right, let's find out where it's at. Is it on the screen? I've had some issues with things happening and, it not zooming to where it actually needs to be. Cyclops, uninvited guest, go to unit. He's actually down here at the very bottom of the screen, which, yeah, okay, kinda, yes. Cyclops. I'm not scared of the Cyclops, if I'm honest. Not really scared of it at all. I probably should be. Let's grab the guard. We'll give them a chance to redeem themselves. Why don't you guys, come on up here. Get up here with the dogs. And let's get the B, C, and D, and we'll move them up as well and give them a little bit more. And let's go to the alerts and get the citizens in Borough 1. I really like that you are trying to bury Katten. I respect that a lot. Just hoping you don't get eaten by a cyclops. It looks like you may. All right, let's see. B, C, D, let's set that to a kill order, and hopefully we can get them out before you die. All right, yeah, no, it's going to be fine.
Gira.
All right, here goes the attack. Cyclops is fighting. Cyclops misses, lots of misses. The militia punches the Cyclops in the lower body with his right hand, bruising the muscle. Makes him sick. Steel spear has lodged firmly in the wound. Cyclops falls over. Midst of conflict, I feel no terror. Bashed in the lower body. Okay, it's done. It's so done. All right, good job, guys. Good job. And Ast, did you get the killing blow on that? I have improved my observation. I am very satisfied as an artery was opened in his leg. Oh. Looks like Militia 1, steel spear to the head. Probably the one that did it. Moses, do you have a you're just bashing him with a featherwood shield. You had a battle axe. Steel spear. Leg. Wait a minute. Yeah, tearing the brain. Yeah, so it was Kivish. Kivish that got that kill. Fantastic. Boy, a lot of stuff going on in this episode, eh? In the last two episodes, we got the siege, we got the Cyclops. Lots of stuff. Canceled the guard station order. And get back to life as somewhat more reasonable. All right, a lot of mess to clean up there. You know what I noticed is that it's working, but it's not working like it used to. Let's cancel that task. Let's try this a little different way here. Levers. Let's remove levers. And why aren't you doing levers? That's the question that I have that nobody seems to have an answer for. Why do you not have to do levers? Sure, there was a good reason for it. Don't know what that reason was. All right, take levers off of all of these people. Remember to put them back on as well. We're just taking them off for now. And, you know what? I wish I would have kept that because I actually need it. Let's see. I think that was Mistum, if I'm not mistaken. We're going to take all the labors off of you, Mistum. Every single thing but lever pulling. And we're going to commit that. All right, and let's add a task to pull the lever now on repeat and see if that works out a little better. And while I'm over here, I wanted to check the military skills of some of our military folks and see if that. Boy, it's really hard to tell, isn't it? Looks like everybody's doing okay, though. We're moving into labors. That'll show us health stuff, right? No, I guess just happiness. There's a health tab that we can do. Lacerations. Breaks and fractures. Exhausted. Yeah, I'm gonna consider that an all-around win. All right, so that's kinda. This is Mimish, I assume, or Mistum. There, she's like going off and then coming back, going off then coming back. It used to be that the guy would just sit here and take that up and down and just do that forever. That appears to not be the case. But that's okay. That's all right. This will work just fine. All right, let me get you out of your cycle there of terror. All right, we'll give that a shot in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching. We did get rid of the alert. We did. I really appreciate it. I will see you next time. Have a good one.